Assalamu alaikum, myself Ehkam Ansari, a student. I am back again with yet another video lecture of Impressive Web Designing. In this particular video lecture, I will be talking about one of the important lecture in JavaScript, that is data type in JavaScript. What is data type? Data type means a data is nothing but an information or a set of information. If I say my name is Ehkam, means I am passing an information. If I say my roll number is 123, means I am passing information. I have shared two information. One is my name and another is my contact number or my number or my roll number, you can say. For example, my contact number is 12345 and my name is Ehkam. So I have shared two information. Now these are two information or these are two data. But what is the difference between these two data? Okay, I just want to tell you, I will start, for example, notepad. Okay, so I will show you what is different between name and contact. For example, I write my name as Ehkam and I write roll number as 123. So these are two information or these are two data. Okay, these are two information. Ehkam is my name and 123 is my roll number. These are two information, or you say in technology you can say these are two data. So if I ask what's the data type or what's the type of data, so you will simply say it's a collection of character. Okay, means name can be a collection of character, but roll number cannot be a collection of character, because roll number is nothing but a number. So what's the type of this data? This data is nothing but a type of number, and again this data is nothing but a type of character, or in IT the collection of character is called as a string. It's a collection of character. I have totally 5 character, A, H, K, A, M. okay, it's a collection of character, but in IT a collection of character is called as a string. Okay, so what is the data type? This is the data. And what is the type? Which type belongs to this data? This data belongs to string type. In the same way, 123 is my roll number, or you can say contact number, whatever, but it belongs to a data type which is nothing but a number. Okay, so in the same way, if I write my date of birth is 11-1990, for example, so this is again a number, but it's nothing but a date. So to store date, we have a special data type called date time, or whatever different language name as a different, but the data or information can be of different type. Okay, can be of different type. Like it's a collection of character, it's called as a string. In the same way, it's a collection of number, or sometime it's called as a number. So this data belongs to number data type. Okay, so in the same way, you can, if you suppose you want to perform addition of two number, you want to write 2 plus 2. Okay, so in that case the data or the unit, in general you say unit in mathematics. Okay, can you add 2 plus Ehkam? If I say 2 plus Ehkam, is it possible to add two different values? Because the unit is different. This value belongs to number and this value belongs to character, so we cannot perform addition. Okay, so it means finally we come to know that everything is called as a data or information, but the type of data can be different. So to store information or data in computer, we have to write or we have to use the data type. Okay, so in JavaScript is a computer programming language which supports n number of the data type, and accordingly we store data by using JavaScript, and we use this information in the form of data type. Means according to the data we store or we manage this information. So in we will see what is the data type in JavaScript. Finally, I think you got the answer. What is actually data type? Why we use data type? Okay, so let's have a look what data type JavaScript supported. So we are in our first chapter, that is Impressive Web Designing, and our topic is JavaScript. In this we are learning data type in JavaScript. So what is the data type? Finally, you come to know means which type of information you are going to store. The type can be of character, can be of date, can be of number, or we have a number of the type. So we will see one by one. The first thing we will see that this is the definition. I think it's a tougher definition given in the, your computer, but I have given example what is mean that. But finally, I think now you will get clear picture what is data type. Let's have a look. In computer programming language, a data type or simply data is an attribute. Attribute means it's an information, it's a feature. Okay, if I say the word this is what is this information, again this is an information, but what type of data you can say, sir, it's a collection of character. In the same way, if I say it's a one, it's written one, so what is the data type? So you can't say it's a collection of character because it belongs to number. Okay, in the same way, there is a, some example called 5, 6, 7, it's a collection of number. Okay, all it's a number, you can say. So finally we move to our definition that in computer programming language, a data type or simply type is an attribute of data which tells the compiler. In previous lecture, I have told you what is compiler or what is the interpreter. Compiler or interpreter is a middleman of your computer which converts your computer language, which converts your programming language into your machine language. Okay, so finally your compiler will check which data type you are using and accordingly it converts your value. For example, if you write number 2 plus 2, so it will your compiler or interpreter understood that you are using number. But when you write 2 plus AB, again it will confuse how it's possible to add 2 plus ABC, because ABC is belongs to different unit or different data type and 2 is belongs to different data type. So your interpreter, how the programmer intend to use the data, means you are which data you are using, your compiler will understand on the basis of their data type. So the first thing is that first data type of JavaScript means every language have supported Java supported data type and they have named differently. So in JavaScript, the first data type or the first one is a number. First one is a number data type, or simply you can say number type, or you can say only number. So if you are going to assign a number data type, or which type of data come in the category of number data type, let's have a look. So numerical values, if I am talking about numerical value, so you can simply say numerical value means all the value, negative value, positive value, float value, decimal value, all the value which belongs to numerical value or belongs to number data type. Please read it, that numerical values especially belongs to number data type. Okay, all the numerical value number data type stores, okay, or whole, you can say both whole number, that is whole number are called as an integer. If I say a whole number, what is a whole number? Whole number are the complete number like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are the whole number, means which are not decimal number. Okay, or decimal point means decimal number also come in the category of number data type, and decimal number is also called as a floating point number. In examination there can be a question like decimal number are also called as a dash. So decimal number, that is your 2.5, 2.6, whatever, means if the number is in point or is in decimal, so this number is also called as a floating point number. So these data type, these data are come in the category of the number data type. In the same way, like we have positive number 1, 2, 3, 4, or sometimes we write negative number like -5, 6, that you get the minus symbol before your number. So this number belongs to the negative number. So if these are the information, these are the data, so these data are belongs to number data type. Okay, now next we have string data type. In starting of my lecture, I have told you the collection of character is called as a string. Collection of character means if you have only one character, for example, if you notice S, so if there is a S, it is a character. But if it become more than one character, for example ST, so ST is a more than one character, so ST become a string. Okay, so collection of character is called as a string. So all the collection of character is come in the category of string data type. And in string data type, are written or saved with the double inverted comma or single inverted comma. This line is very important. Means string values are stored or saved or declared in the form of double inverted comma or single inverted comma. For example, see the example, there is a keyword which is used to declare a variable. Okay, there is a keyword here, and what is the x? X is a name of variable which holds some value. Which value it holds? Hi, I am Ahkam. So I am Ahkam is a data, is a value, and which type it belongs to? It belongs to string type, and this value is written or stored in double and comma. See, this is the in at the opening of the your string, at the end of your string you have to put double inverted comma. Okay, so this will become an string. In the same way, you can use single inverted comma also. Where m, what is the where is the keyword to declare a variable, and what is the m? M is the name of variable where you are going to assign some value. Which value you are going to store? That is a welcome to KMS College. So welcome to KMS College is a value, and which belongs to string data type. Why? Because before that string there is a comma, and at the end there is a inverted comma, and again at the end of there is an inverted comma. Okay, so string means the collection of character. The third data type is very important. Okay, that is a boolean. What is mean by boolean? Boolean means either true or false. What is mean by boolean? Boolean data type is used to store only one possible value at a time. Okay, only one possible value at a time means, for example, if you have a power board or switch board, in which we have n number of the keys or in number of the button. So the button can be either on or off. Okay, in the same way, if you have a question like you have to select whether it's a true or false, so you can use only one value at a time. Okay, sometime if you are online, so sometime your status could be online or offline. So these are two possible value which you can store, and that value is belongs to boolean type or boolean data type. Okay, are you getting my point? So boolean data type is used to store only one possible value. That value can be true or false, or sometime it's called on and off, or sometime it's called a yes or no. Means only one possible value can be stored. If this type is this situation comes, in that case the data type will use as a boolean. Okay, now move to next, that is infinity. Okay, infinity data type, it's a very important, just you have to remember, if you divide any number by zero in JavaScript, the whole concept I am talking about, it belongs to JavaScript only, because every language treats these things with their own manner. Okay, because the definition, the language creator is different for different language. So if I am talking about only JavaScript, so all the rules and regulation, all the data type I am talking about, it's only for JavaScript. So we have infinity data type, which means if a number divided by zero, the output always be infinity. Okay, just remember it. Okay, if you divide any number, for example, you have declared a variable called where x equal to 3, and now you are going to divide by 0. Okay, so the result will be infinity. Okay, in JavaScript only. And the second last, that is a null data type. What is mean by null? Null means nothing. In JavaScript, null means nothing. Okay, so in Java, null is just means nothing, empty or unknown. If you declare any variable, mostly it's not declared with variable. Null data type is declared with the object. Right now you are not able to understand what is the object, because now you are in standard 11. Once you move on toward 12 standard, or once you move on advancement of JavaScript, you will get what is the object. Actually JavaScript is a object oriented, and object oriented is a big concept that is similarly called as a OOPS concept. So in OOPS concept, it's a big concept. In today's most of the language are supported by OOPS concept. So in OOPS concept, there is everything is considered as a object. So null data type is used for object, where you can, if you assign null data type, all the elements will be considered as a null. Okay, so we will see once we move on, but that right now just try to understand. Null data type is used to declare as a nothing, but it's mostly used with the object. Okay, now our last point of this lecture is this undefined data type. What is mean by undefined? At this name, undefined means we have not defined any value to a particular variable. Okay, and now you are going to access that value. Okay, for example, I have declared a variable called where age. Okay, where age, I have declared a variable called where age. So the name of variable is age and where is a keyword. So now I am going to write alert age. So this will alert up alert box. This will display an alert box and it requesting to a value of that age, but you have not defined. Okay, I want to show you this one. So I will just move on to notepad. Okay, I will start coding. So I will write doc type HTML. I am moving fast because this thing we have done in number of the time. So HTML and closing HTML, then head tag. Okay, then closing head tag, then body tag, then closing body tag. Okay, now these are the basic HTML tags, HTML element which we need to write every time. Okay, now we have to add JavaScript, so we can add inside the head tag, that is the opening and between opening and closing, or even we can add inside the body tag. So most of the time we have done inside the head tag. Now in this particular video lecture I will use body tag. So to insert any scripting language, we have to use a tag called script tag. So I will write script tag. Then we have to use an attribute called language, which shows which language you are going to use. So we have two language, or we have a number of language: JavaScript, LiveScript, VBScript, but we are working in JavaScript. So I will write JavaScript. Okay, now I will close script tag and I will mention the forward slash. Now this is my JavaScript language part. Between these two tag, what will I will write, it will consider as a JavaScript part. So I am going to write where icon. I have declared where icon. Now I am going to write document dot write. What does it mean by document dot write? Document dot write is an object. Document is an object. Write is a method or function which is used to display, write anything on your browser. So if I write, for example, if I have written where acom equal to 50. Okay, I have written where acom equal to 50 means I have declared a variable which name is acom and which value is 50. So if I write acom over here, means I want to access the value of that particular variable. So when I save the file, let me save the file, click on save. So the first time it will ask where you want to save. Currently I am saving on my computer desktop, so I will say it's okay, not an issue. I have to assign some name, so I am going to write acom data dot html. This is the file name. You can mention any file name, but the important thing or compulsory thing is that you have to write dot html extension. So you have to save the file. Now when I move back to my desktop, when I search my file, this is the acom data. When I double click, means I am going to run the program on my browser. So you will notice that you get the correct output. Let me zoom it. so you will get your output. Now you are getting 50. Why you are getting 50? Because you have written where acom equal to 50. What is the acom? Acom is the name of variable, and what is the value you have assigned? You have assigned 50. If you add 5, so you have to change, save the file. Now you have added one more zero, that is your value become 500. So when you go back to your browser, refresh the file, your value will be 500. Now see what will happen if you won't assign value, means when you remove this value, means you have only declared a variable. You have declared a variable by using where keyword, and the name of variable is acom. Now you are going to write the value of that variable. So in this case, you will get undefined error. Okay, you will get undefined. See, undefined you are getting. Why? Because see, JavaScript written undefined when a variable which is declared but not assigned. You have declared a variable. You have declared a variable. Which variable you have declared? You have declared a variable called acom, but you have not assigned any value, and now you are going to access the value of that particular variable. So the value is not declared. How you can access? That's why you are getting an error of undefined. Means the data which is stored is undefined. The data which you want to access is undefined. Are you getting my point? Okay. In the same way, now we have created our program, so we can check some different data type. Like this one we can check, means infinity. If you want to declare any variable, but if you want to divide with zero, check it. For example, I have declared a variable acom equal to 95. Okay, now I have declared acom equal to 95. Now I am going to divide it. For example, I am going to divide by 0. Where acom equal to 95 divided by 0. Now I am going to access. Okay. When you save the file. Okay. Flip back to your browser. When you refresh the file. What you are getting? You are getting infinity. Okay. You are getting infinity. So these are data type in JavaScript. Now if you want to check with some other, for example, you have declared variable called kmes equal to now you are going to write welcome to KMES. You have written. Now you are going to access your value. It will execute or not? Student, I am asking with you. If I run this program, means I have declared a variable. The variable, where is the keyword? And my variable name is a KMES. And I have written some value, welcome to KMES. Now, instead of acom, I have to change with KMES. So I am going to remove this and I am going to write KMES. Why I have written? Because now my variable name is KMES. So I want to access value of that variable. So I have written document.write and KMES. So the value of KMES will display. Currently, what is the value of KMES? It's a welcome to KMES. So my expected output is welcome to KMES. But whether it will work or not, it will not work. Okay? It will not work. Let me save it, then I will show you why it will not work. When I refresh, you are not getting any output. But if you change this value, let me comment it. In last lecture, we have seen how to comment. So I have commented this line. Okay, now this line will not execute. Again, I am going to copy this and I will paste over here. I will remove this comment. Means this line is commented, this line is not commented. Instead of welcome to KMES, if I write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, when I save this file, now you will get output. Okay, now you will get output 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, where is my, sorry. Okay, now you will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why? Means why it's coming. Initially it was not coming. When I return welcome to KMS College, the output was disappeared. There was not correct output. There was no output actually. But when I change the value to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the program has been run and it was the correct output, because the value of KMS over is 1, 2, 3, 4, and I am expecting the value of KMS. So the value of KMS is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But in this case, in above line, when I execute this line, why it was not showing welcome to KMS College? Okay, why? What was the error? What is the mistake? Because this belongs to number data type. This line belongs to number. This value actually belongs to number data type. Because if you are going to write number data type, or if you are using number data type, you are not supposed to use any double inverted comma or single inverted comma. The only thing is that you have to use any number. Okay, you have to use any number. Any number means it can be positive number, negative number, decimal number, floating number, integer number, full number, whole number, whatever. If I write 1.2, this is the decimal number or floating point number, it will show the output without any problem. Okay, let me show you. Now you will get some point over here. Okay, means it will accept, it will access your floating point number. Even if I write negative sign, that is a minus sign, again if I save the file, again it will show you minus symbol, that it will access. Okay, but why it was not accessing, not showing the output as a welcome to KMS College? Because you are storing, please pay attention, here you are storing I-string. I-string means collection of character. This value belongs to a string data type. So a string data type, it's a compulsory to put double inverted comma before a string and at the end of the string again double inverted comma. Now I am going to comment this line, means this line will not execute, and I will uncomment this line, means this line will work. When I save this file, now this line will execute and you will get welcome to KMS call, welcome to KMS. Okay, let me show you. When I refresh, you will get welcome to KMS. Why? Because now I have stored this value in the form of string. And how we write string? By using double inverted comma. So before and after you have to put double inverted comma. You can put double inverted comma, or even you can put single inverted comma. So instead of that, you can put single inverted comma. So it is okay. Let me save the file. Let me change little bit in KMS College. Okay, let me save it again. Now flip back to your browser, so you will get KMS College. Okay, welcome to KMS College. Why? Because we have added double single inverted comma. Now this data, this value is belongs to string data type. Okay student, hope you could understand. This is a very important in your programming language. Without data type, you can't do, or you cannot perform your programming effectively or perfectly. Okay, so that's it for today. Thanks for watching. If you have any query related to this topic, data type, please feel free to comment or ask your query. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.